Welcome to WebStylePress. Arrays are one of the most fundamental building blocks of every popular and practical programming language. In this video, I am going to cover everything that you need to know about and understand arrays. So what is an array in JavaScript? Array is a special variable that can hold a list of values. In JavaScript, a variable can hold a value like let identifier name and then value. Let r equal sign 1, r. This single value can be a number or a string and more. But when we need to store multiple values in a variable, array can be used. For example, let s, and here is the array, containing items. This set of values is an array stored in a variable called s, declared by using let keyword. Okay, and why do we need an array? So consider this. Fruit 1, fruit 2, fruit 3 are three variables holding same type of items or data. We can use one variable named as fruits and store these items in it. Like let fruits equal sign banana, apple, orange. Single variable containing all these items. That is why we use arrays to store multiple values in a single variable to avoid declaring multiple variables where we can use one. So array is used to store multiple values in a single variable, or you can say that array has list of items. Array can store different data types like numbers, strings, boolean values like true and false, objects and so on. You can test a variable if it holds array or not. Like array dot is array. Inside parentheses, provide variable name or identifier, and if it is array, it will output true. If not, it will output false. True means this identifier is an array or holds array. You can find index of an element in an array. Fruits.index of, let's find index of orange. And it is 2. 0, 1, 2. For apple, it's 1. For banana, it's at index 0. Array index starts from 0. Arrays are special type of objects. Type of empty array is object, or type of this array is object. Array has properties and methods. Length is one of array's property. Empty array's length 0. Length for this array is 6. Length is number of items present in array. So how can we create array in JavaScript? To create an array in JavaScript, we open and close square brackets. This array is an empty array. It has got no items inside it. We can create a variable and store this array in it. We created an empty array and stored it in WSP identifier, declared by using let keyword. Empty array is undefined. It is declared, but it has no value or item in it. So it's undefined. But we created an array even though it is an empty array. Here is how we can use values in it. This method of creating array is called array literal method. We can also create array by using array constructor. Let identifier name, and this is array constructor method to create an empty array. It will also create an undefined array. We can add values in it. And display those values by calling it. So these are two methods of creating array. Array literal method and array constructor method. In arrays, list of items is stored inside square brackets and separated by commas. Each item is separated by a comma in the list. It's common to declare array with const keyword, but you can use let as well. Const cannot be redeclared or reassigned, but it allows you to add or delete values from it. An array declared by using const keyword cannot be redeclared or reassigned, but it allows you to add or delete values or items from it. So how to add items in array in JavaScript? This is an array declared by using const keyword. This is empty array. We can add items in this array by using push method in array. Array name or identifier, push 1. And 1 was pushed in that array. Similarly, we pushed 3 items in array. We can also push strings. These were numbers, and here is the string. We can also push array inside array to create nested array. Let me show you this in console. F12. And these are the values that were pushed. There are 5 items in array containing numbers, string, and array. Array push will add item at the end of array. If you want to add item at starting position, use unshift array method. Array.unshift, and here is some data to add in the beginning. Pushing values in an array that has been declared using const keyword is not reassigning values to const. And this can be a good JavaScript interview question. You can use const keyword to declare array and change items in it. Okay, so how can we replace items in array in JavaScript? Consider this array with identifier cars with values Honda, Volvo, BMW. We've got an array with 3 items in it. Honda is at index 0. So let's replace it. Cars 0, and it shows us Honda. Equal sign. We are assigning it another value, Toyota. And now if we see cars, it shows Toyota, Volvo, BMW, and Honda was removed. Before value was this, now it is this one. Honda has been replaced by Toyota because we targeted index to replace item on that index. Okay, how to get values of arrays in JavaScript? We can access values or items of array by using item index number. Array index starts with 0. Consider this array with identifier s containing 3 items that are numbers 1, 2, 3. To access first item, we will use its index s 0. Second item s 1, third item as 2, and if item does not exist on index being used, it will be undefined. Item at index 10 isn't available in this array, so it is giving us undefined. Similarly, here is another array with identifier things containing milk, bread, and eggs. To access items in it, we will do a similar thing. Things index 0 will give us milk. Things index 1 will give us bread. Things index 2 will give us eggs. And things at index that is not present will give us undefined. How to create a nested array in JavaScript? Array can take any data type. You can add objects inside array to create a nested array. You can add arrays inside arrays. For example, here's an array. These are numbers. This is a string. Here is an object. Next, we can have an array inside it. And here is the nested array. If we use dot length property, it tells us that we have got 7 items in this array. 4, 5, 6, and 7. Let's add another object here. Let's add another property here. And property for this object. And give it an identifier. An array. Now this is our array. And here is how we access data from a nested array. For example, we have to access this price only. To do that, we'll have to go to index number 6. Then inside index number 6, we'll have to access data at index 0. And then we'll have to name the price. Like an array, 0, it will give us 1. 1, it will give us 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now here, we access index 0 and then we'll name the key to access its value, and that was 200. Let me show you in console. See, this is index 6, and then index 0, and then price. So array has got properties like length and several methods. There are many array methods. Methods like array shift. Methods like array push, array shift, array pop. Array methods help you manipulate arrays. For example, this is an array with identifier elements 1, 2, 3, 4. To reverse elements order, use reverse method on this array. Like elements dot reverse. And see, order has been reversed, 4, 3, 2, 1. To map through elements in array, use elements.map, then identifier, and then we can use that identifier to manipulate the array. Like here is the result. We added 1 in each item present in array, and result is this 2, 3, 4, 5 instead of 1, 2, 3, 4. You can use array methods to apply several changes to items or get a different result without changing original array, depending on requirement. We will cover array methods in detail in another video and link that video in description below. For now, I guess this is a good introduction to JavaScript array. I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.